Frank told John that in many contacts with the ETs, he mostly saw human-looking Nordics, meaning that they looked like blonde-haired people from Scandinavia. He also occasionally saw tall dark ETs from Saturn, small dark-haired humanoids, and short grays, the most commonly reported ET type. Both George Adamski and Howard Menger said that the grays travel to Earth from small permanent bases on Mars and that the Nordics are mainly from small bases on Venus. Dozens of contactees report face-to-face meetings with ET races of different types, including bizarre ones. Some people have seen 7-foot-tall humanoid-like reptilians with scaly skin and slit-like pupils. Others have seen 15-foot-tall humanoid-like mantids that look like praying mantises with stick-like legs and arms and 3 claw-like fingers on each hand. Frank saw multiple civilizations on other planets and said that the ETs in most advanced cultures that he saw were humanoid. That is, they had 2 eyes, 2 legs, and 2 arms, although they had highly variable skin textures and colors. Preston Dennett reported dozens of interviews with contactees, who also described ETs as humanoid, with some relatively minor differences. Upright walking humanoids seem to be the most common body pattern across the universe, possibly because walking on 2 legs frees up arms for manipulating objects. Most contactees describe the grays as having grayish skin, as their name implies. They typically range in height from about 3.5 feet to 5 feet. They have oversized heads, pointed chins, large almond-shaped black eyes, slender legs, long skinny arms, and 3-fingered hands. They typically have no apparent ears but have small noses and narrow slit-like mouths without lips. Their arms and legs appear spindly because they spend a lot of time in the low gravity of space and because they evolved on a planet with lower gravity than Earth. They simply don't need large muscles and have lost them of millions of years. Besides, they have long been able to control gravity on their ships, adjusting it lower to be more comfortable, and therefore, they need fewer muscles. It is rare to find accounts that the grays speak or make any other vocal sounds. Instead, they always seem to communicate telepathically. There is some question about whether they even have vocal cords. It's the old use it or lose it principle. They don't need vocal cords, and so they have disappeared. Contactees typically describe the grays as wearing one-piece skin-tight bodysuits that seem tightly molded to their bodies, so that some observers consider them to be nude. If so, no contactees have reported grays with genitals or nipples, consistent with eyewitness accounts that the grays usually appear to be androgynous. However, there are occasional reports of gender differences. For example, Dennett reports that several contactees saw what they interpreted as a female gray. Some writers claim the grays reproduce through cloning, which is not entirely accurate, according to Frank. The major drawback to cloning is the lack of genetic diversity so that if a particularly virulent epidemic occurs, a cloned species has too little genetic variability to survive. So, the grays don't use cloning the way we think of it. Instead, they extract genetic information from 2 or more individuals and combine them outside the body. They don't need sperm or eggs to do that, they accomplish it using normal cells. In general, the ET races have different tendencies. The grays never seem to express emotions with contactees, and instead are typically analytical and rational. They are the ones that most often seem to abduct people, who frequently describe them as appearing to lack compassion during their investigations. Similarly, one ET from Saturn was aloof and distant, much like the grays, except more so. On the other hand, the Nordics tend to be much friendlier and more compassionate. It is common for the grays to tell an abductee, "Don't be scared. We're not going to hurt you." However, they sometimes perform medical examinations that can be painful. Most of the time, however, the pain is brief and minimal, no worse than a bee sting or getting a shot from a doctor. Many contactees report that among all the ET races, the grays are the ones most interested in human genetics and reproduction. Some claim the grays are creating half-human, half-gray hybrids that they are raising on board ships or bases within our solar system. In one encounter on an ET ship, a contactee described a room full of giant bell jars with babies growing in them. The fetuses appeared to be human-gray hybrids. The contactees report several reasons the grays are doing human reproductive research. First, they claim they are unable to breed the way we do and are conducting experiments to produce fertile hybrids. Second, they are concerned that the upcoming Earth changes and war on our planet will be so severe that the human race will become sterile. At worst, humans may become extinct. To prepare for that possibility, they conduct genetic engineering to produce a new breed of hybrids that is better adapted to our planet after the Earth changes. Also, they store humankind's DNA to preserve the original non-hybridized species, if it is ever needed in the future. Some reports claim that the grays also are cataloging and storing the DNA of many of Earth's animals and plants for future use, if needed. It's a modern-day version of Noah's Ark, except with DNA instead of actual animals. Some of the ET races, including the Nordics and Greys, have reputations for being tricksters and riddlers. They have a childlike sense of humor and enjoy putting humans in puzzling or confusing situations that require problem solving. Whitley Strieber mentions that the Greys who visit him like to create friction in their interactions with humans. It seems to be their way of teaching. These descriptions remind us of folk stories about leprechauns, also called the little people. They pose riddles to unsuspecting humans as a way of tricking them. Could those old folk tales have arisen because people in the past came face to face with trickster grays?